This is Quick Q, and if you have a science or technology question, your camp guides have answers. I'm Vanessa from BrainCraft, and I'll be your camp guide today.
Hi, Vanessa.
Can you explain how thumbnails make a video successful?
For this, I actually want you to think about why you click at different thumbnails when you're scrolling through YouTube. So let's do a little experiment. I want you to look at this thumbnail compared to this thumbnail. Now, this one is really bright. You can see my face smiling in the middle, where this one's quite cluttered. There's lots of stuff in the background. There isn't as much contrast between the colors. And I want you to think now about which of these you would click. And what I can tell you about your brain is that it probably wanted to choose this thumbnail because of the colors. So your brain is attracted to really bright colors and also human faces. Humans are social creatures, right? So you want to hear from me here, and your brain tells you that's the one you want to see.
I know your concentration is on the brain. What do you find in the brain that's so beautiful?
Well, I think it's the most beautiful, but also most incredible thing in our body, because your brain, it's only 3 pounds. It's the same consistency as jello, and it's just smushed inside your head. And yet it's responsible for all of your thoughts, all of your feelings and emotions, all of your behaviors and actions, whether you're running or you're happy or you're curious, like that all happens just from this lump of jello that's inside your brain. Isn't that crazy?
What inspires you?
When I was young, I was curious about everything. I loved walking in nature and fishing and looking at the stars. When I went to university, I studied brain science, but I also studied creative writing. And what I realized was that science communication is a whole field within STEM, and now all of the amazing science that researchers are doing out in the field, in their labs, and the fact that I get to talk to them and then talk to the world about it is really, really cool. The other thing that inspires me are my audience on YouTube, my subscribers who always have lots of comments and questions and who make me want to share all of the awesome stuff with them.
What have you been doing for fun this summer?
I started making a balcony garden where I started trying to grow herbs and different vegetables. The problem that I had was that I didn't have enough drainage for the plants, so they all died. But now I've learned, I've done an experiment, I've seen the results, and I know how I need to plant my new seedlings, which I'm gonna do very soon.
How did you come up with the idea to do this?
When I was working in science, I was teaching students about all areas of science, but what I found, we weren't actually talking about the bits of science that relate to our lives, like how can we have a better memory? How can we study better? Do naps actually help us? So what I wanted to do was make a YouTube channel that would answer those questions and bring science and really cool science research into our everyday lives to make it more relatable for all of us.
What advice do you have for girls like me who love video production and science? What should we be studying in school and what should we be working on?
First of all, you should definitely study science. STEM education is so important, but also all of the tools that I have learned in STEM, I definitely apply to video production. And you can learn more about, say, how your camera works by studying physics, like what happens when light goes into the lens and touches mirrors and lenses and all that kind of stuff. But what I would say is to experiment just like you would in science, but with camera equipment and with video production as well. So just make things, and creating things is the most important thing you can do if you want to be good. Learn all about science, and then one day, maybe like me, you might start making short films about science. Check out Basecamp at GoldieBlox.com, where you can start your adventure now. To dig for some fossils, check out Cool Tools in the description with Miria, who's a paleontologist. Her tools kind of look like something you'd see in the dentist's office. Subscribe to my channel, BrainCraft, and learn lots of fun things about your brain. And stay curious, fellow campers. A big thank you to Lyda Hill Philanthropies for making this all possible.